Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. This video is intended to save you a few pennies if you've got a Celestron C90 telescope and you'd like to use it to do some photography with a digital SLR. It can be a great way of taking pictures of the moon, for example. Now, you've probably worked out that you're going to have to buy some kind of adapter to connect the telescope to the camera. And generally, there are two parts to this sort of adapter. The first part is called a T-ring. So here's an example of a T-ring. This one is for a Canon digital SLR. One side you have an adapter that screws into the body of the camera when you remove the lens, and on the other side you have a standard thread. Now you can buy one of these for a Nikon camera, Sony, Canon, many types of camera that as long as you can remove the lens, then it's worth seeing if you can find a suitable T-ring. So inexpensive, easy to get hold of, no real problem there. The issue can come if you search the web and you're looking for the second part of the adapter that would then go between the T-ring and the telescope. So you might find you come across a unit like this. So it's labeled, as you can see, T-adapter C90. And I think what we can say is that this T-adapter works with some models of the telescope, for example, the Celestron Nexstar 4SE, but it's labeled C90, right? So you think it's gonna work with the Celestron C90. Well, you'd be wrong. So if we remove the accessories from the back of the telescope, so take off the visual back, the erecting prism, and the eyepiece, then we can see the thread that's on the back of the unit. And this would be the point where you'd expect the T-adapter to screw onto the back of the telescope. So here we go, here's the adapter. Let's see if it'll fit. It doesn't. The threads are completely incompatible. Okay, so if it's C90 adapter, maybe it fits the old C90. So I've got one of those. Here it is. So this is the back of the old C90, and well, it looks more promising. The thread looks like it possibly could be the same. And indeed, if we attach the T-adapter, it will thread onto the old model of C90. So there we go, just tightening it up, it's a bit squeaky. So that is as far as it will tighten. The problem is, you can see there's play. So as it is, this adapter isn't any good because you're not going to have a rigid mounting between the camera and the scope. So if you wanted to use it, you'd have to pack out a spacer to remove that play. If you do that, some people report that you still have problems and you can't focus the scope at infinity. So overall, I have to say, even though some other users reported that their C90 Astros can use this adapter, I have to say in general, it doesn't work with C90s new or old. Okay, so what do you use in its place to connect the camera to the scope? Well, here's the rub. If you remember, we looked before at the visual back that comes with the new C90. So here it is. When you get your scope, you attach it onto this thread at the back. Okay, no problem. And guess what? There's a thread on the back of the visual adapter. Well, that looks a bit familiar. Well, it turns out that thread is already the one that you need to attach the T-ring. So on goes the T-ring, along comes the camera, Bob is your uncle. So it works fine. So what is the moral of the story? I would say if you bought a Celestron C90, still a great scope, you know I'm a big fan of this scope. If you want to connect your digital SLR, all you need is the T-ring. You do not need to buy this adapter. It's a shame that it's got C90 written on it because as far as I'm concerned, it doesn't fit. It's unnecessary. So you probably could be spending a few pounds or dollars that you don't need to spend. But the good news is you can connect the camera cheaply using just a T-ring, and you've got a good rigid mounting between the telescope and the camera, and off you go. Okay, I hope this has been useful. Thanks for watching.